everybody. I'm Elizabeth, and this is Clary's Do Life. If you're new here, I just want to say welcome. And if you're not new here, then welcome back. If you've never watched our channel before, I do a lot of cleaning motivation, mom lifestyle type videos. Plus, we have family vlogs thrown in here or there. We love to do things as a family. And I hope that our videos can motivate you and your family to do fun things and sometimes do the not so fun things like cleaning our house. So my bedroom and my master bathroom are always the last two things on my priority list. For some reason, I'm just so tired once I get to this point. I just like throw my stuff on my dresser or on my floor. My bathroom is always a mess, unfortunately, but we all use that to shower in. So that's part of the reason why. I was just wondering, do you guys have a room in your house that's like the last priority? Like you don't care if it's messy or you're just too tired to worry about it? Let me know in the comments what that room is in your house. So today's video is jam-packed full of cleaning motivation for your home. Plus it includes some fall decor. And I am really excited to share this with you. This is actually part one of a two-part series for my clean and fall decorate with me. And that was Caroline who just came in my office. Say hi everybody.
Hi everybody.
If you were here for one of the videos I've done before of Caroline's room, you probably noticed she still does not have trim in her room, which is just really funny at this point because it's been well over a year. She doesn't have like the baseboard trim. You can see like the burgundy paint from what it was when we moved in 8 years ago. And what's funny is like now our dining room, which is this room we just redone, it also needs baseboards now because we redid it. And then our living room still needs it. So we're gonna wait till wood prices hopefully go down, and then we're going to put new white trim up. So whenever I redid this room, I got new curtains, and whenever I took the rod down to paint, apparently I lost the little rubber piece that goes in the middle to help it not fall apart. So every time I touch the curtains, it just falls apart. If anybody has a solution for that, let me know, because I would be happy to try it. This room was our living room and is now our dining room, and it's still a work in progress, but I am loving it so far.
Here's my real dilemma. I love this because it matches my rug and it just looks pretty. It does have something on it, but that's okay. I love this because it has the traditional fall colors, but it has stains on it, so I may be getting rid of that. And this I love because it's got the greens in it. And a little bit of blue, so it kind of goes in here too. I can't decide which one I want. I think this one is prettier because I have an obsession with these roses, but I don't have any flowers that go with it. I'll probably end up with this one in here unless I decide to do one in the living room. And here's just a look at all of my stuff. Oh my goodness, there's so many pumpkins.
Auntie.
You see all my mommy's pumpkins, Caroline? Got lots of them. I have like glass ones. I have metal ones. I have these super cheap like hollow ones. What do you think, Caroline?
So pretty.
So pretty. Are you excited to help mommy decorate?
Uh-huh.
Yep. What should we start with?
The flowers? Okay. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Elizabeth Clary, and I live in Southeastern Ohio with my husband of a little over 12 years. His name is Wes. We are high school sweethearts, and we are so blessed to have a wonderful family of four children. Our oldest, McKenna, is currently 10, which is crazy. Briella is 7.5. Layton is about 6.5. And Caroline, which you see in this video a lot, is 2.5. So we have been blessed to raise this family here in Southeastern Ohio near our family, and we love to teach them that it's so good to work, but it's also so good to just enjoy quiet time and fun time with our family. So more about our renovation here in this room. This used to be our living room, and I hated that I had to come in from my garage straight into my living room. And so whenever we had a water leak on one of the doors in this room, we had to replace them completely and replace the flooring. We decided it would be just really smart and kind of cool to move the house around. So we made this our dining room. We have a coffee bar there in front of some of the doors that you probably noticed, and that's actually my great grandma's buffet table, and I love it because it's just so cool to have something that's antique and that is a family heirloom in my home. So I noticed whenever I was getting decorations this year for fall that I was really drawn to kind of the muted fall colors. I do love color, but I also love neutrals. I'm just really easy to please, I guess, because I like everything. But I did notice that once I got all of my decorations together, the majority of it was kind of muted fall colors, and it all looks so pretty in my house, especially in this room. This is actually the very first white room I've ever had in my entire life. We always loved colored walls and lots of color, and I still do, but this room, I just wanted it to be bright and airy and kind of just have a neutral palette so I could decorate for all the seasons in this room and not have to worry about it clashing with a wall color. So I'm really pleased with my white walls and then my muted fall colors. I think it looks really pretty together. I'm really in love with this wreath too. I got it at Walmart for $9.98, and I regret so much not buying more than one of them because it was just really inexpensive and it's so pretty. Now it is not the best quality for sure. You kind of get what you pay for, but that's okay. I'm pleased with it. This table is something that we purchased whenever we bought this house 8 years ago, and it is so special to me. It's one of my favorite items in my house. Whenever we moved here, I wanted a big, long table, and that's exactly what this is. It has a built-in leaf, so it folds up underneath of it so I can see less people, but I like to keep it out so that everybody who comes over has a place to seat, and there's plenty of room to add like stools or extra chairs on the corners because it's just a large table. And it may look like it's in pretty good condition from a distance, but it is all scratched up, and it actually has M-A-K carved in it backwards because whenever McKenna was probably about 3 years old, I caught her carving her name in the top of it with a fork. And so she got the M-A-K and it's backwards on the table whenever I caught her, and I just think it's really cute. I've laughed about it ever since. I never was even mad about it. I just thought it was funny. Now that white truck, it's from Hobby Lobby, and it is a new thing that I got this year. My mom actually bought it for me. I've not been really a huge truck person like a lot of people are. I don't dislike them. I just have never found one that I really loved until I found this one. And I'm excited because the back side of it does not have anything about pumpkins on it. So I'm going to decorate it for Christmas and just turn it around and probably put some pretty reds and greens in it. This is actually the first tiered tray I've ever done. I've always wanted one, and my mom gifted me this because she saw it kind of at the beginning of Hobby Lobby's fall decor stuff whenever they started putting it out, and she brought it to me one day and surprised me, and I have loved it ever since, and I've waited until fall to be able to decorate it. It's hard to find all of these little tiny items that will fit because it's not that big of a shelf, and mine actually is kind of crooked on top. You can see me, I keep trying to adjust it and it just is crooked, but it's no big deal. It's fine. Everything that's on this I got at Hobby Lobby except for one or two things. There are things I already had, or maybe I got at Dollar General. I can't remember exactly, but most of it's from Hobby Lobby, and I do really love it. It's again the muted greens and creams, and I put this in my kitchen because I decorated everything in my kitchen with more of the neutral tones, and I put more of like the oranges and stuff like that in my dining room and my living room. By the way, if you're still here, I would really love it if you would subscribe to my channel and make sure you ring that bell. That way, whenever I load part two here on YouTube, you can see how my living room turned out, decorated for fall. Here I'm just using the Mrs. Meyers multi-surface cleaner spray. I believe it's the pear scent, which smells pretty good. It's not my favorite. I usually like the cider scent. I think it's apple cider or something like that, mulled cider. I don't remember the exact name of it. I love Bluebell as well. It's probably my all-time favorite because it's just a nice clean scent. But I'm currently out of it and I can't get it right now because it's not on the Grove website. I don't know where else you can buy them at. I've only ever bought them at Grove. Maybe Target? I'll have to check it out. But I really like the acorn spice smell. It's also a really good fall scent. But I do not like the pumpkin spice at all. I've used that because I had bought it, so I did just use it up. But I really don't like the scent of it, to be honest. Does anybody else feel like they go through a million snacks a week? My kids have been coming home from school starving every single day, so I have to have a pre-dinner, and then a couple hours later I have regular dinner, and I feel like they snack all evening long. It's so funny, but my kids really like just like chips and crackers and sandwiches and things like that. What kind of snacks do your guys' kids like? I wanted to keep the decor in my kitchen really minimal. I don't like a lot of stuff on my counters, and so I've been trying really hard to keep them nice and clean and straightened up. And so I just decorated my window here and a little bit around it, and I'm really happy with it because it's not cluttered. I bought command strips to hang these wreaths with, and they are probably the worst ones I've ever used. I don't know if maybe they're just old or something and they're not sticky, or maybe they got in some humidity and the stickiness is not working right, but they keep falling off the doors. And this candle is the pumpkin apple edition from Aldi. I've now purchased 4 of their candles. They're only $3.99 and they smell amazing. And I'll be honest, I haven't used candles hardly at all over the last several years. I'm a pink zebra girl all the way. I love pink zebra so much, but I just love candles in fall and winter time because it's cozy and just so awesome to be able to smell these fall scents. Now this is at the end of my kitchen. This has been a catch-all for about a month and a half where we cleaned out certain parts of our house. Some of it's yard sale stuff. Some of it is gifts that I've bought for like Christmas that I haven't put away yet. Some of it was just decorations that I had taken down from where we just remodeled. There was orders of things, and then there in the bottom corner you can see I had a load of clean laundry that needed folded. So it just really needed tidied and put away and swept. This rug is one of my very favorites that I've ever purchased. I got it on Amazon and it was a really good price and it's really nice quality. It doesn't scoot all over the floor every time you walk on it, which is great. I got it for my living room, but it had more of a blue tone to the gray, and I needed more of like a green tone or just a pure gray because my living room is now a cream color and a mossy green, and so it just did not go, but I could not get rid of it because I loved it so much. So I moved it in here to the end of my kitchen, and I'm really pleased with it. Now, one thing we plan on doing, hopefully in the next few months to a year or so, is put a whole new set of cabinets down here. We wanted to do it whenever we remodeled 3 years ago, but unfortunately we just ran out of money, so we've kept it just as a pretty wall, which I've loved ever since, and it's totally okay with me. But we've been needing an office space because right now I have a clothis, which means my office is in a walk-in closet, so there's not a lot of room and we really could use the closet space. So we're going to make kind of a little office out of the cabinets on the bottom, and then have a pantry cabinet there on the left against the outside wall, and then cabinets across the top. I think it's gonna be really nice and so helpful because we really need extra storage in our house for just our office supplies and my party supplies, because I love my party supplies and I just have a lot of it, and I use it several times a year for my kids' parties and anything else, any other get together I have at my house. So I'm super excited and really looking forward to that. These dishes are dishes that my grandma gave me whenever we got married, and I have a ton of them. That's the second box of them I have. I did leave some of them in this cabinet, which this is also my great-grandmother's cabinet. It even has the original glass in it. It's probably like 75 years old, I would guess, at this point, or maybe even more, I'm not sure. But I wanted to just add different decorations in it because the china has been in there since we got married 12 years ago. So I tried to mix it up. I did leave some of the china in it that my grandma gave me as a wedding gift on the bottom shelf, and then mix it up with some newer decorations and other antique dishes that I love. So that just about rounds it out for today's video. Remember, this is just part one of a part two Fall Clean and Decorate with Me series. If you want to make sure you can get that notification whenever I load my next video right here to YouTube, make sure you hit the subscribe button and then click the bell so you get a notification whenever it is here for you to watch. If you'd like to follow me on Instagram, go follow me at Clary's Do Life, and I would love to chat with you and get to know you. Make sure you comment below and subscribe so that you don't miss any of my videos. What are you waiting on? Go ahead and hit it. Thanks again for watching. Remember, it is cheap to be clean and it is free to be kind. Have a great day, everybody.